Quack TV. Good afternoon, Duck fans. We got a huge game coming up this weekend. It's the biggest game, well, since the last game. Now, both teams, both the Ducks and the Tigers, they've had off-field issues. I mean, Oregon seems every summer they have off-field issues, but they always come through. They always get over the hump. But one thing, three things I'm thankful for. This summer, there's been no mention of any player by the name of Masoli on the Ducks roster getting in trouble, so no Masoli. There's been no mention of any stolen laptops. You know, there's been no mention of any, no pot. Huh? What? You're kidding me. Darren Thomas. Okay. Scratch that left helmet. Small mention of some pot. But he swears he didn't inhale. So that's okay. So I guess, we can't win them all. Neither can Jordan Jefferson. But seriously, you know, this Saturday at the Cowboys Stadium, you're going to have Ducks. You're going to have LSU. Ducks, number 3. LSU, number 4. They're going to be playing each other. It is the most hyped game of the summer. If not, I think the biggest game of the year. You know, it's gonna decide the Ducks' future, and it's gonna decide LSU's future. So, seriously, I mean, the way I see it, it's gonna be the Oregon's up-tempo, you know, attacking offense versus LSU's tough, gritty defense. You know. To be honest with you, if you look at the other side of the ball versus LSU's offense, the quarterback, not so important. I mean, if you look at last year with the suspended quarterback, Jordan Jefferson, I mean, he had 7 touchdowns and 10 interceptions. 7-10. I mean, you know there's got to be something wrong if you have more interceptions than touchdowns. You know, versus Darren Thomas. He was a freshman last year, and I believe he had about 30 touchdowns. So, he had a few interceptions in the bowl game, which I would like to forget about. But anyway, you know, if you compare Darren Thomas, Jordan Jefferson, well, he's not playing now because he got into a fight leading up to this game. I mean, who in their right mind would jeopardize their whole collegiate football career right before a big game? Wait, no, who would jeopardize their career, whose name isn't Mussolini, leading up to this big game. So now the backup quarterback, Jarrett Lee, who was a prior starting quarterback, who pretty much in the beginning of his career at LSU, pretty much he sucked. So you're gonna have Darren Thomas. We'll see who comes out on top. But seriously, this game, I mean, it's gonna be Oregon's offense, Oregon's up-tempo, fast offense, attacking offense versus LSU's tough, gritty defense. And that's what it's gonna be. And we're gonna find out in a couple days who the winner is. The first one that comes to mind is obviously their offensive line. They retired numerous players last year, numerous starters last year, and especially on their offensive line. So that's the first worry. Definitely, because they've got to get people to step up to become team leaders for their offensive line. Second one. Who is going to be this year's Jeff Mail? I mean, last year, I mean, Jeff Mail was friggin' awesome. I remember that touchdown pass where he tapped the ball to himself and caught it in the end zone. Oh, man, that was pure sweet. Pure sweetness. So, two biggest X factors for the Ducks. One, offensive line. Two, who is going to be this year's Jeff Mail? Two big X factors for LSU. One, obviously, their quarterback, Jarrett Lee. Is he going to be the same quarterback in the beginning of his career when he... he sucks? Or will he be improved? And I think the biggest one is going to be their reaction to George Jefferson's arrest, their team leader being kicked off the team. I mean, how are they going to react? I mean, I think the biggest plus for the Ducks is the fact that forever, they've always had off-field issues, but they've always kind of, not always, most of the time, come together, and especially last year, when Michael James got suspended for the first game, and they end up going to the national championship game. So, the Ducks, they've always found a way to come together as a team. It sounds corny, but the whole win the day. So that's a big X factor for LSU. Do they have the ability to win the day?